This is a video showing how to use temperature sensors to teach exponential functions. So I started this experiment by having two temperature sensors in a hot water bath and one temperature sensor in a cold water bath. At 5 seconds, I transferred one of the temperature sensors from the hot water bath to the lower temperature water bath. Because it takes a finite amount of time to transfer heat to the temperature sensor and have the sensing element register that temperature change, it shows a decaying exponential function here. In order to analyze this, we're going to transfer this function back to the y-axis. I'll do that by selecting the smart tool at the top of the screen and then go down to add alignment tool. So as I move this along, it's going to try to track on data points. You can see the arrow extending out and touching data points on the curve. You want to select one of the first points after the temperature has changed from the initial water bath temperature. Once I've selected that, I'm going to select the down arrow, and then I'm going to align this to the y-axis. So that shifts this curve back to the zero point in time. Next, I'm going to select part of my curve here. So I'm going to select on my selection highlighter area, and I'm going to select the data point just to the right. I'm now going to go up to my curve fit here, and I'm going to go down and select my natural exponent. You can see the curve fit for this natural exponential function. So you can see that it's going to asymptotically approach a value that's a little bit above where the bottom temperature is for the cold bath. One of the reasons for this is that the temperature, if you can look very carefully, the temperature of the cold water bath is increasing because the high temperature probe that I transferred over is bringing some heat to the solution. So this is a way that you can use PASCO Capstone and sensors to help teach the exponential functions.